Okay, you're all set. If you need anything, I'll be right up.
Shh, the living lighthouse is on. The living lighthouse is on.
Okay, I just want to make sure that if you need...
Mom, if I can learn to not talk when it's important, why can't you?
No joy, a talking baby who talks back.
Hello, boys and girls. It's a ton of fun dancing a Sunday today at the living lighthouse. Wouldn't you say so, Lashes?
Ton of fun. Dance in the sun. Ho, ho, ho.
Lashes.
Lashes. He's so goofy.
Hey, Scoopy, what are you gonna show us today?
I was thinking, how about me own? Jolly out of England.
Yes. We could go to England and see Big Ben, a giant clock. Where's Big Ben?
England!
That's right. Big Ben's in England. You're very smart.
Mom, Dougie said I'm smart. And I am, right?
Tell me. I can talk now?
Well, it's off to the salt mines.
I didn't know Beverly Hills had a salt mine.
Oh, yeah. It's right next to the Neiman Marcus. It's got valet parking and everything.
Dad, you're just in time to watch The Living Lighthouse with me.
The Living Lighthouse?
Bob's favorite show.
Dougie and I are going to see England.
Who's Doug? The man dancing in the sailor hat?
Not Doug. Dougie. And he's a boy, not a man.
Lattice, you're tickling me.
Or something vaguely in between.
Dougie's all wet.
Man, I had no idea that The Living Lighthouse was his favorite show.
Oh, yeah. But last week it was Arthur, and the week before that it was Sesame Street. Oh, and for a while there, it was the Monistat commercial, because it had a bunny in it.
Dougie.
Wow. He really loves that Dougie. I wonder if I could arrange for Bob to meet him.
Honey, don't feel that you
hey,
have
Bob,
to...
Hey, Bob, how would you like to actually meet Dougie?
Wow, you can do that?
Sure.
You're the best dad in the whole world. I'm gonna meet Dougie, Mom. Yay!
Yay! If you don't come through on this, what are you gonna show us next, Scopey?
Why, it's a great big look of disappointment on your wee child's face, Governor.
So now we say goodbye with a heavy heart and a sigh. But hey, now don't you cry, 'cause it's only toodaloo till tomorrow. Toodaloo, kids!
And cut! Promos up next!
Excuse me, Walter Spencer, I spoke with your assistant earlier.
Yes, Walter, thanks for coming.
Oh, sure, Doug, thanks for seeing me.
Actually, it's Doug E.
Oh, I thought that was just for the show.
Oh, everyone does. But see, here's how it works. On the show, I'm all Doug E. But off the show, I'm just Doug E. Helps keep me sane.
Yes, well, I'm pretty much just Walter all the time. Yes, sir. Okay. So anyway, I'm a huge fan of your work,
Do you
Doug
believe in fate, Walter?
Sure.
Because just last week I was thinking I should hire a publicist, and boing, here you are.
Boing.
I don't get nearly enough media attention for what I do. And you know how I know you're the guy to help make that happen?
No, I don't.
You came here to meet me, not so your kids could meet me.
So people do that, huh?
All the time. So, how do we do this PR thing? I want to start like yesterday.
Oh, hey, here's an idea. How about if you come by my house later tonight and we could talk things over during dinner?
Right. Walter, when you say fan, you don't have any ulterior motives, do you?
No. Why would you think that?
Your house, dinner, tonight. It's just some older gentleman get the wrong idea about me.
No, God, no, Dougie, no. I'm my wife will be there.
Oh, all right then. See you at 6?
Sure.
Yeah, well, you know, leave your information with my assistant.
I will do that.
You know, Walter, yes. I like the way you operate. Hmm? You're very professional.
Well,
we're like two peas in a pod. I don't see Mr. Salty on my shoulder!
Dougie's gonna be here any minute. Everyone excited?
Okay, now, Bob, I know this is going to be hard, but please remember...
Not to talk in front of Dougie, I know. But really, Mom, he lives with a talking telescope, a talking toaster. You'd think he could handle a talking baby.
This may be the high point of your son's little life. How did you pull this off?
Well, Dougie doesn't actually know that he's coming to meet Bob.
So why is he coming?
It's open to interpretation. Dougie thinks that he's coming over for me to represent him, and I don't.
So you lied to him?
Do you hate me?
No. Come on, Dougie can benefit from your advice, and you're doing this for your son, not for personal gain.
Boy, when you put it that way, it almost makes me sound like a hero.
You are a hero. Mm. You big liar.
Dougie's here! Get me! Get me!
Oh, honey, here. These are from Bob.
Oh, what are they?
Well, since he can't talk to Dougie, I told him that you'd ask him a few questions.
Well, honey, I don't know if I...
If you don't, he will.
Dougie, hi, come in.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, my, look at that. You're still in costume.
But this? Oh, heavens no. My show shirt is blue and yellow. And I'm done with the show, believe me. I leave Dougie behind. Mm.
Well, Dougie, this is my wife, Lizzie.
Hi. I'm a big fan of the show. Bob and I watch it every day.
Bob?
Yes, this is our son, Bob.
Oh, you didn't mention you had kids.
I didn't? That's... odd.
Ahoy there, Bob. I'm Dougie. I tell our producers we can appeal to the pre-verbal demographic. Well, here's our proof. Is he always like this?
Always like what?
What a happy family. Hey, Walter, as I was talking yesterday, it just got my mind racing. And okay. I just thought that we...
Oh, yes. Listen, before we get into all of that, Doug, I wanted to ask you a few questions, if you don't mind. Yeah, just to get to know you a little better.
Your daddy's very smart and well-prepared.
I was wondering, when Lashes licks your face, is his tongue really, really, really wet?
Walter, Lashes' tongue is made of cotton.
So, no... wetness.
No.
Okay, see? We have a bet.
You win.
How come you and Patchy the pirate look so much alike? Are you brothers?
I play both parts. You saw me do them on the show today.
Oh, that was Patchy the pirate. See, I thought that was Honolulu Harry. Oh, speaking of which, Honolulu Harry eats a lot of bananas. Does he smell like a monkey?
Walter, I don't know where these questions are coming from. I just... Oh, I see. By asking me these ridiculous questions, you're getting me to see me the way the world sees me.
Oh, am I that transparent?
How do I change that, right? Because I'm a serious actor. I mean, I want to work with directors like Scorsese and Coppola. How do I make that jump?
It's not unprecedented.
Right. Morgan Freeman was on The Electric Company.
Yes, and Lawrence Fishburne was on Pee-wee's Playhouse.
Yeah, and Fishburne played one lousy part. I played seven.
Really? I only counted six.
I do the voice of Captain Napkin.
I did not know that.
Nobody does.
See, but the thing is, Dougie, their careers didn't really take off until after those shows had ended. You'd need a radical change of image. You know, while you're this strongly associated with the Living Lighthouse, I'm afraid that it would be, virtually impossible. Say, how about a picture with you and Bob, huh?
Wow. You don't pull any punches, do you?
I'm sorry, but it's just that my professional opinion is it's just not gonna happen. How about with the two of you on the couch, huh?
Okay, scooch in together real close. Big smiles.
You're right. I can't play Dougie anymore.
You know what? Maybe one with him right on his What?
I'm going to leave the show, just like you advised.
Wow. Your daddy's not just smart, Bob. He's an A, B, C, D, E, F genius.
This is a Lifesavers Fusions. It has two flavors, like watermelon fused inside cherry. Yes, that is intriguing. Well done, Diane. New Fusions, the hard-to-ignore hard candy.
Where is your mother?
At the JCPenney Saturday one-day only sale. Big savings store-wide. Doorbusters, 8 a.m. till noon. Dad, it's only one day.
It's all inside.
JCPenney.
It's time to get to Lens Crafters and get glasses or sunglasses for only $99. Choose from great-looking sunglasses with your prescription or a complete pair of glasses with super scratch-resistant DuraLens for only $99.
Hurry. Offer ends June 28th.
Well, the girls have been sharing a wireless phone.
Yeah, I can help you out here.
Now, buy one Samsung A460 phone for $49.99 after savings and get a second one free, instantly, only at Sprint stores. PCS from Sprint, clearly a whole new way to look at wireless.
Test drive a new Mitsubishi and buy one, you get a cool new car. Buy one of our competitors' new cars, you get $100. That's the Mitsubishi Challenge. Best case scenario, cool new Mitsubishi. Worst case scenario, $100. It just might be the biggest no-brainer in the history of no-brainers. The Mitsubishi Challenge. Great deals, great warranty, great time to buy.
What you got there?
It's a McGriddle sandwich from McDonald's.
What's in it?
It's good. It's like a bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich. Except, it's got these two griddle cakes with the taste of maple syrup inside.
That's bizarre. Then again, it's not that bizarre.
New McGriddles. Bizarre, but yummy.
Dad's almost done. Pin them?
Where's your mother?
At the JCPenney Saturday one-day only sale. Big savings store-wide. Doorbusters, 8 a.m. till noon. Dad, it's only one day.
It's all inside.
JCPenney.
The three little pigs were charming. 3,000 little pigs are not. You could say they stink. And we will. Sunday on 60 Minutes.
Something unexplainable is happening to Joan Girardi.
I've known you since before you were born.
Do you believe in God?
Joan of Arcadia, coming this fall to CBS.
So, has it started yet?
Almost. I'm not really sure that Bob understands that Dougie's not on the show anymore.
Well, we couldn't have explained it any more clearly.
Hey, guys, you think Dougie will wave to me now that he knows who I am?
Honey, remember we talked about this? Dougie left the Living Lighthouse.
He always leaves, Mom. He says, it's toodaloo till tomorrow. And then he always comes back.
Yeah, but Bob, I'm afraid that Friday was the big toodaloo.
Starting.
I hope you sea dogs all wiped away the sleepies, because it looks like a fantastic day here in the Living Lighthouse.
Who's that?
I'm Jimmy.
That's Jimmy.
Dougie's brother.
Dougie's brother.
Dougie's brother?
He doesn't look at all like Dougie.
Well, maybe they have different mothers. You know how sailors are any port in a storm.
Dougie's on a sailing trip around the world, and he asked me to take care of the lighthouse.
What? Why'd he leave? Didn't he like me?
Oh, honey, sure he did. And I'm sure that Jimmy will like you, too.
I hate Jimmy. Dad, we need to get a boat, go find Dougie, bring him back.
Look, here's the thing, Bob. Dougie isn't real.
Walter, maybe you should...
Sure he is. I met him.
That's not Dougie, okay? That's just an actor who plays Dougie.
Well, what's his name?
Dougie.
I don't get it.
I, I know that this is hard to understand, okay, but the living lighthouse isn't real. Dougie doesn't live in a lighthouse. He lives in an apartment in Encino.
He doesn't live in a lighthouse. Who takes care of Lashes?
The prop guy. See, Lashes and Scopey, they're just puppets. That doesn't mean that we can't enjoy them.
Is everything I watch on TV make-believe? Like Blue's Clues and Barney?
Well, pretty much, yeah.
So, today, Scopey's gonna show us the Eiffel Tower in Paris. Where's the Eiffel Tower? Paris!
Aw, he didn't give me time to answer.
And her name was Thumbelina, and she slept on rose petals in a bed made out of a peanut shell.
Sure she did. Next!
Okay. How about a story from Dragon Tales?
Ever seen a dragon?
Well, sure. In the book.
Nice try. Next!
Bob, we've been through almost every book you have. You don't like any of them.
That's because none of them are real. Face it, I've been spoon-fed one big whopper after another since the day I was born.
You shouldn't give up on make-believe while you're still so young. You've got your whole life to do that.
Sorry. The lying little engine that could has left that station. Don't you have any books that aren't fake?
My chemistry book.
Okay.
The building block of all matter is the microscopic atom.
Are atoms real?
Well, sure.
Ever seen one?
Bob, you can't see an atom. They're too teeny tiny small.
Sure they are. Next!
Well, it was no picnic getting Bob to sleep. He poked holes in every lullaby I know. He neither believed Baba Black Sheep could talk, nor would freely offer up his wool to be shorn.
I can't help but feel that this is somehow my fault.
Which part? Convincing Dougie to leave Bob's favorite show, or completely shattering a young child's sense of fantasy?
Well, another fantasy debunked. The supportive wife. You know, it's not easy knowing exactly when to lie to your kids and when to tell them the truth.
Always go with the truth. When you ask where babies came from, I didn't fill your head with all that stork or cabbage patch nonsense.
No, you called a doctor friend who brought me down to watch a C-section. Spent the rest of the afternoon sobbing in my kindergarten class.
I think that there's nothing more important to a child than fantasy. One of my fondest memories is still of my grandmother reading to me from Grimm's Fairy Tales. Translated from the original German.
You read those to me. They're full of beheadings and disembowelments and cannibalism.
Yes, and as enchanting today as the day they were written.
Madeline, you were just upstairs. If he doesn't believe in witches now, a book's not going to help.
You know, the problem is Bob talks with such a grown-up voice that I sometimes forget he's a baby. You know, protecting his innocence was the whole reason we wanted to keep his talking a secret. Now I've taken that innocence away from him.
Oh, it's bound to happen sooner or later.
Well, I would have preferred later. There's got to be some way to give it back to him.
Might I suggest Rumpelstiltskin? The end, when he pulls his leg so hard, he rips himself in two. Magical.
Now, it's official. It's not really summer until you have your ballpark.
Only ballpark Franks have such a big, juicy taste. They plump when you cook them.
Don't you just love summer?
This holiday, come celebrate at the Payless Red, White, and Shoe Sale. With shoes for the whole family starting at just $3. Hurry, sale ends soon. Look smart, Payless. Cheerios and strawberries have finally gotten together. New Berry Burst Cheerios. Real strawberries, together with those classic O's. For a taste you can really fall in love with. New Berry Burst Cheerios. In both strawberry and triple berry.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's beautiful hardwoods, stunning ceramic or porcelain tile,
and every kind of carpet imaginable, all at the guaranteed low price. And right now at the Home Depot, it's no payments and no interest until January 2004 on any flooring purchase of $299 or more. Just use your Home Depot consumer credit card. Plus, get free carpet pad with purchase and installation through the Home Depot at-home services. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Washington's newest congressman.
We're positively giddy that you're here.
Has America laughing.
You finished here, Congressman?
Why? What have you heard?
Nathan Lane is Charlie Lawrence, CBS Sunday.
CBS Tuesday, July 8th. Get into the most outrageous house party of the year.
Hey, Big Brother!
13 new faces, 3 incredible nights.
It's on. Hello.
Plus, a surprise twist. So unbelievable, all of America will be talking.
Scandalous!
An all-new Big Brother premieres CBS Tuesday, July 8th.
Challenge your kid to a race. Shoot some hoops. Go for a bike ride together. Get active and have fun.
Broadway.com brings you everything Broadway. But how do they do it? Broadway insiders working tirelessly to bring you tickets to the best on Broadway. And the hottest behind-the-scenes gossip. And their work doesn't stop there. They've also picked out the best restaurants and great places to stay, like the Hilton, DoubleTree, Embassy Suites, and Waldorf Astoria. So you can put together Broadway hotel packages that make your trip a showstopper. Get it together at Broadway.com. They get you in like no one else can.
Book your Lancaster County vacation. Visit PADutchCountry.com for money-saving offers or call 1-800-PA-DUTCH.
When will the rain finally end? The answer, Eyewitness Weather at 11.
So this whole thing with Dougie, it's hit you pretty hard, hasn't it, Bob?
Yeah, but at least now I know the way things are. From now on, if I can't see it, touch it, or put it in my mouth, it's not real. Believing in things is silly.
Well, maybe it is and maybe it isn't.
What do you mean?
I mean, I used to not believe in things that didn't seem real. And then something amazing happened that changed the way I feel about all that.
What happened?
You started talking. And I never believed anything that fantastic could be real.
Wait a minute. So I'm not real?
You're very real. That's my point. See, you talking is just as hard to believe as all those things that you don't believe in anymore. So who knows? Maybe I was wrong before. Maybe those things in books and on TV are real.
I don't know.
I'll tell you what. Why don't you sleep on it and see what happens, okay? You never know what new ideas might come to you in the night. Wow. Did you hear that?
Yeah, it's probably just the house settling.
Are you sure? Oh, look! It's Chucky from Rugrats! Ah! Oh, it's okay. He's real. Ah! Okay, all right. Back in the closet, Chucky. Back in the closet, Chucky. Okay, Bob, here we go. No more Chucky. No more Chucky. No more Chucky. Okay.
Hey, Bob, look who it is! It's Arnold!
Doesn't like it. Back in the bedroom. Back in the bedroom. No, Chucky, no! Get out of here! Chucky, get out! We're going downstairs now. Everything's okay. Okay. Whoever's at the door, we don't want any.
Anybody home? Why, yes, Blue. Bob is here.
Huh? Oh, we're dead. Wherever you are, abort mission.
You'd better take Bob outside, just for safety's sake.
No. A Long Island iced tea has vodka, not gin. You're sinking on the mission. They're coming.
Where? And their heads are huge and scary.
Okay, but you believe they're real, right?
Yes, they're real. And they won't stop until we're all dead.
Look, Bob, it's corduroy.
Ah!
Get him out of here.
It's corduroy.
Get him out.
I don't want any of of them in my house. I want them in books and on TV where they belong.
It's okay, Pop. Grandma's here.
Well, Bob made me empty his entire closet, but I finally got him to go to sleep.
Well, at least you brought fantasy back into his life.
Yes, along with abject terror. How's that world's best dad trophy coming along?
Oh, should be arriving around the same time as Dougie's Oscar. What?
I keep feeling like there's something I'm forgetting. And that'll come to me in the morning. Time for the Living Lighthouse.
Oh, honey, I don't think that's a good idea.
Hello, boys and girls.
Dougie's back. Mom, Dougie's back. I don't believe it. I mean, I do, but how?
Well, I guess Dougie came back from his trip around the world.
Or at least from Encino. Wherever that magical place is.
Now, how about an explanation for those of us who have teeth?
Well, Bob needed fantasy back in his life, and Dougie needed a dose of reality, and the reality I gave him was he's perfect for that show, and nothing else.
But the most impressive things in Egypt are the pyramids. Where are the pyramids?
Egypt.
Hey, Bob, what do you say? Daddy goes into work late today, and we watch the Living Lighthouse together, huh?
I guess.
Bob, what's wrong?
I miss Jimmy.
Jimmy?
Yeah, can I meet him?
No.
That's right. Egypt.
The Pizzone is back at Pizza Hut.
What's a Pizzone?
It's just $2.99 when you get any large pizza at regular price. A big taste and a big folded pizza crust filled with cheese and luscious toppings. No one makes the whole family happy like Pizza Hut.
So this is a Pizzone.
Gary, it's time I taught you something every man should know. How to eat an Oreo cookie.
Twist it off. Just give it a lick. Now you just learn to tie your shoelaces and you'll be all set.
Only Oreo.
Chicago asking folks, how should ranch dressing taste?
Yummy and good.
Good creamy base, like Hidden Valley Ranch.
This is exactly what I'm looking for when I taste ranch dressing.
When I think of ranch, I think of Hidden Valley.
Hidden Valley Ranch dressing. We made it first, we made it right.
This is the taste that I expect. I wouldn't add a thing to it. I'll take nothing away.
Hidden Valley Ranch, the way ranch is supposed to taste. A new Hidden Valley barbecue ranch. All ranch, a taste of barbecue.
Simon Cowell has a twisted new idea.
Thousands of men will try to win the heart of America's most eligible woman. First, they'll have to get past her two best friends.
We are going
to
weed out the losers.
That's your hair.
I paid for it.
You won't believe what guys will do and say to impress her.
I want to fall in love with you.
Who will get a shot?
Welcome to Cupid.
And who will get shot down?
You think I'm tough? Wait till you see these three.
Cupid premieres CBS Wednesday, July 9th.
Don't go away. Yes, Dear is next on CBS.
CBS Monday. What's the cast of Yes, Dear doing on JAG?
Can you believe you're on a Hollywood soundstage?
I can't believe I'm out of the house.
Catherine Bell and David James Elliott guest on Yes, Dear. Then a father and son moment from Still Standing.
You never told me you're on the debate team.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Oh, you're good.
Yes, Dear, followed by Still Standing, CBS Monday.
The Late Show's all new.